there. Hello, everyone. Bandicoot Commando here, and welcome back to Medieval. There we go. Last time, we went back to Scarecrow Fields with our new broadsword weapon, and were able to obtain the chalice. Then afterwards, we went to the Pumpkin Serpent to take on the Pumpkin King, Jack Skellington. And not only did we went back to the Hall of Heroes with the chalice to get a new weapon, the spears, but we obtained a dragon gem from the Pumpkin Witch, which we're gonna need. Now today, we're gonna move on. So, after that, once you're done with the pumpkin nonsense, I suggest you go up here to the Sleeping Village. Ooh, the Sleeping Village. That poor little girl's swirly eyes. What do you have to say?
Poor villagers. The master possesses them. It mustn't hurt them. Hurt guards, though. They seek out an object of great power.
Thank you. Can I squish these rats? Oh, you can. Okay, what the gargoyle was saying, though, is that you gotta avoid the villagers here. Do not kill them. You kill them, and you're gonna regret it. Otherwise, you will not acquire the chalice that is deep water. So even though I have to put up with hearing how annoying they'll sound, I can't hurt them. There's a gate there, but we can't get through it. I don't know if he can fall in the water or not, but I do not want him to. I mean, you can hurt him, but just don't kill them. Oh, it's a fountain. We'll need that. Okay, what's this say? We're in a church. A crucifix once stood here, but the mayor took it. Find a replacement and see how the church should really look. Technically, it's a crucible. Ooh, nice jump there, girly. A crucifix is, oh my god! Get away from me! They're so hell-bent. The rune key is held aloft by the flow of water from the fountain. We may have to wait for the next drought. Or we can solve a puzzle. Oh my god, these little killer Red Riding Hood girls want to kill me. Oh, they won't stop chasing me. They're like B Hood, whatever, what's her name, from Darkstalkers. Okay, we're in the blacksmith. Good, I need a new silver shield. Blacksmith's Monthly. Old man Willie Green of Gallows Town was awarded Smithy of the Season by our readers. His outstanding cast have produced many intricate and hard-wearing iron goods and sculptures. Willie only uses the finest of metals in his work and is particularly noted for his magnificent bust. Old man Willie was quoted as saying, "Aye, when I get pumping on me bellows, there's no stopping me. It's all in the rhythm, up and down, up and down. I've always been inspired by the stories of Stanyer Ironhewer, the greatest smithy that ever was." Like this, but there's no point because we don't have any metal in there. Okay, so where haven't I tried? Okay, that's the church. This is where we came from, and we can't go back. It's kind of confusing to navigate. Church. Um, buildings can we not? We can go in here. Oh, I remember this confusing me for a while. La la la, I'm chopping vegetables, even though I'm really not. I'm just holding a frying pan. Alright, we need to come back later. Hey there. I could have you enchant my sword, but I don't need that at the moment. Nope. Get away from me, girly. Looks like I'll have to be careful down here. What does this do? Oh! It even made little boing sounds. Okay, let's carefully get back up. No, can't have you kill me, little girly. Wait. Don't mind me. Don't mind me. Don't mind me. Don't mind me. You're just being a housewife. Oh, you got me. Troll's head. That's funny. Where'd the room? Got it. Where? Get in. I think I'm safe in here. Okay. I am not safe in here. History of Galamir, Volume 1. During the dark time that was Galamir's not too distant past, it was King Peregrin, I think that's how you say his name, who thwarted Zarok the Necromancer in his plan to enslave the land. Zarok, once the king's mage, had fallen out of favor with the ruler for conducting outlandish experiments on the bodies of the dead. It was said that deep within Peregrin Castle that the dead were restless. The dead are to be honored, not kept as the playthings of alchemists, declared King Peregrin, as he banished Zarok from the castle. All of Zarok's living dead were routed out and destroyed. Zarok, being an unforgiving soul, went into hiding and vowed to wreak his vengeance on the king. That's not fair, and I like how Dan's looking at him. Volume 2. Rumors of ill-doing and dark deeds abounded through the land of Galamir. It was whispered that Zarok had employed the aid of shadowy demons to help him build a vast castle. Under the cover of night, Zarok's dark army spilled forth from their corrupt haven. The army marched south across the Silver Mountains and through the Silver Woods. I should say, the Silver Woods is actually very important. Soon afterwards, even the Pumpkin Lands belonged to Zarok. The folk of Gallows Town cried out for help. Save us, good King Peregrin. Retaliation was swift and violent. King Peregrin's forces, led by the brave Sir Fortescue, drove Zarok's army back from Gallows Town. There was much rejoicing, but the war was not yet over. I can't kill him as much as I want to. News that Zarok's army had now taken the floodlands caused much concern. From this vantage point, Zarok could march west to take the Enchanted Forest, or the Enchanted Earth. This sacred place would prove a bitter defeat if it fell into the hands of the evil sorcerer. It was Sir Dan Fortescue who once again led the king's militia to rid the demon host from the land. Yet the evil wizard was cunning and had prepared an ambush. A titanic battle ensued, of which history has never seen since the like. It is said that the day would have gone to Zarok, but for the skill and valor of one man, Fortescue led the charge deep into the massed ranks of the undead, felling Zarok's bodyguard, the fearful Lord Kardok, before finally succumbing to his own mortal wounds, slewing the traitorous sorcerer with a mighty sweep of his sword. Trying to learn history here, pal. The forces of evil were destroyed, but at a terrible price. None but a handful of the king's militia returned from that field. Galamir lost a whole generation of young men that day, including Canny Tim, the legendary crossbowman, and Fortescue's second-in-command, who fell in the first volley of arrows. Zarok's body was never found, though it lies unmourned in an unmarked grave, that no one in Galamir would shed a tear. The shadow demons that had fallen under Zarok's banner were unnatural creatures that did not belong in the world of mortal men. The king declared that they would be banished and entombed under the pure earth of the Enchanted Earth. Imprisoned within an impregnable box at the king's design, the demons were buried deep underground. Their tomb was sealed with a magical device that has since come to be known as the Shadow Artifact. He's gonna kill me at this rate. Tourist Guide to Galamir. The land of Galamir is a wondrous land of breathtaking sights and adventure. If it's beauty you are looking for, be sure to check out the sights of the Enchanted Forest. Scale the heights and see the nest of giant dragon birds. Seek out weird and wonderful plant life. Go ooh and ah at the sight of the baby dragon toads splashing about in crystal clear ponds. Why not take a walk through the Pumpkin Valley? Pumpkin is Galamir's favorite dish. About now, the valley is just budging under the weight of young podlings awaiting harvest. Let's try. If it's mystery you're looking for, then the seasoned adventurer should travel to the ruins of King Peregrin's castle. Yes, this is the fortress from which the fabled King Peregrin once hailed. It is said that the king's crown was lost in the dungeons below the castle, and that the ghost of the regent himself now haunts those cold stone passageways. Spooky! Why not take to the swamps and seek out the mythical town of Melomed? This place was once said to be a place of fantastical, arcane alchemy, but an age has passed since it was consumed by the murky swamps. Perhaps great treasure awaits any adventurer that can locate its watery resting place. Thanks for making me use a life bottle. I need to get back there. Heroes from History, a retrospective. Oh, man. Oh, I see how to get in. In addition to being the strongest man who ever lived, Steinar Ironhewer was unsurpassed in his skill as a blacksmith. He was equally happy pounding on his anvil at home as he was pounding on someone's head in battle. It was said that his only fear was the end of the village smithy as the focus of manufacture in favor of more centralized units. As if... Born a humble peasant to one of the nomadic tribes from the Eastlands, Bloodmoth Skullcleaver gathered an army of horsemen and swept over half the civilized world. When he finally died, attempting a single-handed attack on a garrison in the north while armed only with a spike on his helmet, he was the richest and most powerful peasant of this day. 3. Karl Studengod, that is German, spent most of his formative years under siege at his family castle. With his impregnable magic shield, Sturnegard's motto was, "The best form of attack is defense." Sadly, his shield couldn't protect him against poor eating habits, and he died during a post-battle feast while swallowing a large sausage he had failed to chew. Truly the hero's hero, Wulden the Mighty, was fearless, single-minded, and uncompromising. Unbeaten in combat, he inspired raw fear in friends and enemies alike, not to mention in close family members and pets. Trained from birth in all forms of combat, Imanzi Shogama was the warrior queen of a tribe of Amazons. The bold and the beautiful Shomagama banished all males from her territory, except the handful she kept on to mow the lawns of her people. Full-time mother and homemaker, Megwene, I don't know how you say her name, Stormbinder, had to defend her settlement from barbarian raiders while the menfolk were away on a hunting trip. She fought off repeated attacks, armed only with a pitchfork and a rolling pin, and with one arm holding her baby. Legend has it that the gods, impressed by her indomitable courage, intervened and added thunderbolts to her arsenal. She won the battle with a couple of bolts to spare on her husband when he finally returned. Dirk Steadfast was a fearsome opponent, thanks to his magic sword and a firmly held belief that only women defend themselves. Real men are always on the attack. He was a friend and contemporary of Carl Sturmgaard and was with him even to the end. It was while Steadfast was explaining his views on Sturmgaard's shield during a feast that the latter had his tragic and inexplicable accident. Descended from the finest Sendar bloodstock, Ravenhooves the Archer was the last prince of his people. A proud and haughty aristocrat, he was an accomplished hunter, sportsman, duelist, playboy, raconteur, and 3 times derby winner. Captain of the militia in the time of King Pertigan, Sir Daniel Fortescue found fame when he killed the renegade wizard Zarok. A career soldier raised in the royal household, he was adored by the men under his command and renowned for his loyalty to Galamir. It was said that Fortescue was always destined for greatness. Greatness awakes. With his square jaw, steely gaze, and thick shock of hair, as black as raven's wings, he looked every inch the hero. So yeah, long history of Galamir. Okay, I will need that. To whom it may concern, I must make haste, for Zarok's men will be here within the hour. I have taken the crucifix from the church. It is the key to a key. I used the cross to make the attached cast, then I had it destroyed. It is my hope that this cast falls into the hands of a just and good hero. Signed, the Mayor. Alright, let's get out of here. Excuse me. Okay, so now you know the history of... Oh my god, kids everywhere. You kids should be in bed. I should be in bed too, to be honest. That's the church. Well, I'll look for salvation in the church. Yeah, see? Look at your chalice meter. You attack any of the villagers and kill them, you'll lose that percentage. You will later encounter the guards that gargoyle mentioned, and there's enough of them to fill the meter up, so hold off from attacking. Where's that blacksmith? Oh, wait, we passed it. I remember where it is. Man, they run fast for kids. Well, if I knew that was there. Children shouldn't be up at this hour. Or carrying axes. What kind of parents raised you? Get in. Alright, let's see if this will fit in or not. Oh, I still haven't used the moon room. Do we need to actually put metal in it? I don't know if we need to put metal in it or not. Well, this is how you blacksmith. Yeah, now I'm blacksmithing. Okay, yeah, we're not supposed to do all that yet. I might want to use the moon rune and see what's in that room. It's just been a while. It's, what was that building? Don't hurt me, please. I'm gonna save you. I will save you eventually. I just need to be let through. Where's that house? Where is that house? That's not it. Where is that house? There it is. Okay. You can push these barrels. Oh, you're just a housewife. Ouch. Here we are. Oh, let's see what's in here. There's an entrance there. Oh, goody, a club. Wait. Is there anything in these barrels? Apparently there is. I don't have the earth rune, though. Ouch! Bust of Mr. Shanks, landlord of the Troll's Head. To clean the statue, lower pedestal. Oh yeah, someone's in there. Okay, yeah, I need to lure them away, because there's a barrel in the way. Oh. Just gotta hurt them this once. Man, to think, frying pans is deadly weapons. Get out of my way. No. I can't hurt him. Did I hit it? Yes, I did. Run for it. We need this. Now I remember. We need this as a new cast of metal to do the blacksmith work. No. There we go. Oh, yep. Here come the guards.
Hurry, comrades. Tear this place apart. If we don't find the shadow artifact, Lord Zarak will have us mucking out the demons for the next millennium.
Okay, these guys, these guards are kind of tough. Because they're wearing armor, so either use your broadsword when you have it enchanted, or better to smash them with a hammer. And yes, they are carrying guns, so they are dangerous. What am I doing here? Not done yet, though. A, I have to kill them all if I want to get the chalice. And then I need to figure out where the chalice is again. Oh, here they are. Alright, there's one over there. I think that's the exit, too. Or is that the exit? That looks more like... Yeah, that's the exit. Ooh, man, I gotta hurry. I'm wasting time. Okay, we need to get through there. I think I know how to get through there. First, head to the blacksmith here. Alright, let's melt down this bust. Okay, now we melt it. Wait, is there a... Nope, we gotta do this. Gotta give it a bit. This is how blacksmithing works, everyone. You gotta use them bellows to melt that metal. Wow. That's a pretty looking cross. Okay, to the church. Oh, wait. Let's make our prayers for salvation. Well, fine. We still have some salvation left. Ooh, what does this say? Hey, a safe key. Now we can go in there. What's this say, though? Dear sir or madam, on my travels across Galamir, I have come across many mysterious and enchanting finds. However, which filled me with deepest dread was discovery of the tomb of the Shadow Demons. The key to their dank prison, the mysterious shadow artifact, is now in my possession. That dress-wearing bully boy Zarok will stop at nothing to retrieve this item. I fear that he already knows that it is I who possesses it. Yours, Fearfree, the town mayor. Now we gotta find... Okay, that cross isn't properly on that thing, I can tell. Alright, now we need to head down to the watery area. Nope, not that way. Where is it? That's where we came from. I keep going in circles. There we are. Nope, you're not killing me that easily. Oh. Okay. So what's back here? I was worried I was gonna get stuck. More of these guys. Alright, we just need to kill one more. Hey! There you are! Some treasure. Let's see what's in here. I can't go in there. We gotta take the roof. That's what this is here for. Oh, this is gonna be tricky. Making tricky jumps like this is no fun. There we go. Where's an entrance? Probably in the back. It's always in the back door. Or we could be Santa. Ho ho ho, as I record this, it'll be Christmas eventually. Immersion ruin. Wow, nice treasure. There we go. That opens our exit. Alright, well now that we know where the chalice is, that door should open. Yep, alright. Let's bash him. If I can remotely remember where that... There it is. No, that is not it. Wait, I wonder. Nope, I can't press triangle. Was hoping I could do a dash and run at the same time. Where? I'm lost. I hate this level already. Why am I getting lost so easily? There it is. Oh, boys. Huh? Oh, please. This is too easy. There. That was too easy. Now let's go back. Get our chalice and leave. And I can go to bed. Alright. Okay, that's it. Let's get moving. Alright, see what this says. Instructions from Zarok to his guards. Capture that greedy profiteer, the town mayor. Take him to the asylum dungeons. Give the fat boy a good going over. Locate the shadow artifact. Bring me back something nice. And then profit. Oi. Alright. We can either talk to, Azima again. I don't know how you say her name. Emazima? Nothing? Okay. Or we could possibly talk to, someone else, but now you know who the heroes are because of all that reading I had to do. But let's see real quick. No, we can't talk to her. Interesting. So we have to talk to you instead.
Look at you running around in your bones, Fortescue. You're so nouveau dead.
Good on, Wiffer.
I, Ravenhooves, last prince of the Centaurs, have not galloped the earth in over 10,000 years.
Oh no, and you're dead already.
Do yourself a favor, Fortescue. Take my longbow, more powerful than a crossbow. The option of flaming arrows? It is truly the weapon of noblemen.
Yes, please.
Congratulations! You don't quite have my breeding, Mr. Johnny Come Lately. But there's hope for you yet.
Thank you, at least. The longbow. He mentioned flaming arrows, but we can't get those yet. Stronger than the crossbow, but a little slower. Good damage, nonetheless. But like I said, we don't have the option of flaming arrows. We won't get that for a bit. Can we now talk to you? Yeah, we gotta leave. Well, at least we have the longbow, which we will need. Okay. Alrighty, I'm gonna end it here. That was quite a long episode. And yes, I will save it too. Let's see. Alright, that will do for this episode of Medieval. Join me next time as we do the Asylum Grounds. That is it, and I will see you guys next time.